So if you're like me, you've probably been seeing people online talking about the benefits of Yerba Mate tea, and some are even comparing it to Ozempic. I've seen people actually call it Ozempic tea. Is this really true? Let's look at the evidence. Now, the claim that Yerba Mate tea works like Ozempic is based on the idea that Yerba Mate tea raises GLP-1 levels. That's glucagon-like peptide 1. This is a substance that is actually increased in those people who are taking Ozempic and Wegovy and similar diabetes drugs. Now, as far as I can tell, the evidence for Yerba Mate tea raising GLP-1 levels is this study you're looking at here, which has a very wordy title. However, if you look closely at this, it's actually a mouse study. And the crazy thing about all this is that the study came out in 2011. Here we are several years later, and I can't find any human clinical trial showing that Yerba Mate tea raises GLP-1 levels in humans. And that's weird because this would be a pretty easy thing to figure out. Just give people Yerba Mate tea and measure their GLP-1 levels. So that's the evidence, if you assume it is evidence, that Yerba Mate tea works like Ozempic, which I don't think it does. However, that doesn't necessarily mean that there's no weight loss research on Yerba Mate tea. Let's take a quick look at those studies right now. So in this paper, you're looking at 15 men and women. They're in their 40s. They're given 3 grams of Yerba Mate supplements, and another 15 people are given placebos for 3 months. Now, compared to those who took placebo pills, the individuals using Yerba Mate supplements saw significant reductions in both body weight and body fat. And while that's good, things look a little differently when you look at the actual before and after numbers. Here are some of the before and after numbers that you see in this investigation. And honestly, I don't see a big difference. For example, the people started out weighing about 74 kilograms or 163 pounds, and they ended up about the same body weight. Additionally, in this paper, they also point out that there were no significant reductions in visceral belly fat or subcutaneous belly fat in those who took Yerba Mate supplements. So as I see it, this study is kind of a nothing burger in my book. Next up is this paper, where 33 women, they're in their 40s. Again, they're given either a placebo or 3,000 milligrams of Yerba Mate for 6 weeks. 6 weeks later, the average weight loss in those taking Yerba Mate supplements was 3.6 pounds or 1.6 kilograms it was lost versus 2.8 pounds or 1.27 kilograms in those who took a placebo. In other words, those using Yerba Mate supplements did indeed lose more weight than placebo takers. However, it wasn't much. It only came to about 1.7 pounds or 0.8 kilograms more than those people who took placebos. And then if you go down the rabbit hole even further, you'll find this study, which involved over 18,000 people, and it's concluded that people who drank more than 33 ounces of Yerba Mate tea each day, they actually gained more weight than people who drank less than 33 ounces. Okay, so what does all this mean? Number one, I would say Yerba Mate tea is about 99% water, and water can help fill you up between meals, and in this way it might curb appetite. So that may be one mechanism by which people might be losing some weight when they drink this tea. Although again, I would point out that most of the studies on weight loss don't involve drinking the tea, they're actually taking Yerba Mate supplements. And as for the claims that Yerba Mate tea raises GLP-1 levels and causes fat to miraculously fall off your body, you really want to take those claims with a big grain of salt. I myself remain highly skeptical of that claim, but I'm open to seeing more research, and when it does come out, I'll do a new video on it.